Hi everyone, and welcome back to Spreadsheets for Business. This is part two of lesson four of level two. And in this video, we'll build onto the spreadsheet from our part one video by adding a nested function into an if statement. In this spreadsheet, we're working on creating various financial charges for customer accounts for the zone. In the last video, we built a formula here in column J that met the business rule that we add a $25 past due balance fee if the customer had a past due balance here in column G. The zone also has a business rule that applies to customers that have a 90-day past due balance. I've added it to this cell here. If the 90 days past due amount is greater than 200, then an additional surcharge will be imposed of either $100 or 10% of the 90-day past due balance, whichever is higher. If the 90 days past due amount is not greater than 200, then no additional surcharge will be imposed and a value of $0 should be displayed. I've created another column out here in column K called the 90 day past due surcharge to tackle this new business rule. I've also added a few more rows to our data inputs to hold the value for the minimum 90 day balance for the surcharge that's currently $200. Again, by putting the value up here, it makes it readily accessible in case our business rule changes and our accounting department decides to change this number either up or down. I'll also name this cell minimum 90-day balance to be used in our formula here in a minute. I've also added the minimum surcharge here, $100, and I'll name this cell minimum surcharge. And then finally, I've added the surcharge percentage of 10% here, and I'll call it surcharge percentage. By the way, if you ever want to see what all the named cells are in your spreadsheet and what cells they refer to, you can go up here to Formulas and then click on Name Manager. Here are all the current named ranges, and you can add more from here or modify or delete these that are listed from here as well. Now that we have the parameters set up, let's insert an if function here in column K to build out this pretty complex rule. Equals if. Okay, so what's our logical test? Reading our rule out loud again, if, big hint there, if the 90 days past due amount is greater than 200, that looks like if this cell here in column F is greater than the minimum balance value, remembering that that number is actually stored here in B3, let's put our comma in here to get the next part of our if statement, the dreaded value if true section. Looking back up at our business rule here, if it's true that the 90-day cell is greater than 200, then we want the formula to either render $100 or 10% of the 90-day past due balance, whichever is greater. This is where we'll embed or nest a function in here that picks the higher of these two amounts, the $100 or 10% of the past due balance. Thinking back to lesson one a few weeks ago, we want the maximum of these two amounts. So let's type in max and then a left parentheses. And what do we put in here? It looks like we need the number 100, which is contained in this minimum surcharge amount up here that we called minimum surcharge. So let's type that out. Tab, once we get the whole word there, and then a comma, and then our other value that we want the maximum of, which is 10% of this cell here. Remembering that we stored the 10% in this cell that we called surcharge percentage. I'll start typing in surcharge percentage. There it is. And then multiply that times the 90-day past due balance, which is here in column F. Let's take this opportunity to discuss a visual hint that Excel is about to provide us. It's a very common mistake for Excel novices to lose track of their parentheses in potentially complex nested functions. A rule of thumb is that you'll always have the same number of left parentheses as you do the number of right ones. So if you look at our formula here, we currently have two left parentheses. When we type in the right one, it will glow for a second or two along with its matching left one, indicating what chunk of logic that pair of parentheses currently wraps. Let me put the right one in right here now. Keep an eye on the left parentheses here because it's just going to glow for a second. There. Hopefully the video captured it. So this nested or embedded max function will now correctly capture which of these two values is the larger for us. Let's move on to the last part of our if function by putting a comma here. And now we're sitting here in the value if false area of the if function that we can see because it's bold. Looking back at the last part of this business rule, if our logical statement at the beginning of the formula up here is false, or it is false that the cell is greater than 200, then we want to display a zero. This is the easy part. We just put in a zero here. Let me put in another right parentheses here and watch its mate glow over here, indicating that we now have two left parentheses and two right ones that are matched, so all is well in the world, assuming that they're in the right place in the first place. Hitting enter, we see a dash here, but we wanted a zero according to the business rule. Let me copy that formula down for all these customers. We must have the formatting in these cells set to display a dash for zeros, so we need to fix that right quick. I could go into these cells and do custom formatting and fix those, but I see over here that this column is set up just the way I want it, with the top row with a dollar sign and all these others no dollar sign. So I think I'll just highlight the cells in that column, including the ones with and without dollar signs, and then I'll click on the Format Painter, and then select these cells in my new column. So now our formats match. So let's move on to testing. In order to test out the formula, let's look at all these formulas a bit and the results that we got from them. Here we have a 90-day balance. It's over 200, so we're supposed to pick the higher of 100 or 10% of this, which would be 486. 486 is greater than 100, so we render 486. Cool. In this one down here, 10% of 899 is $89.90. So our max function picks out the higher of 89.9 and 100, so we get 100. Cool again. The last scenario would be to test out the rest of our formula by looking at a 90-day past due amount that is less than 200. So here we have 150. Since it is false that this is over 200, then we go to the value of false part of the formula, and we stick a zero in there, so that's what we get. All right, that's all for now. See you in the next video.